Hello.
Hi, how you doing? What's the state of this?
What on earth am I looking at?
Large police station lantern, pillar-mounted, royal crown to the top. Very simplistic version of it. It's got lots and lots of problems.
First impressions, I feel like the whole thing is going to fall apart on me.
You could be right.
I mean, the door works, which is great.
Not sure how long that'll stay there when you strip the paint off it.
But yeah, that could be the paint keeping it together. I mean, I'm interested because I've never worked on one of these lanterns.
It's got quite a bit of age to it.
Must be an old one. I've not seen one like this before.
Blue lamps first appeared outside police stations in 1861. Lit by gas, their design copied existing Victorian street lighting, but used blue instead of clear glass. The large coloured lanterns shone clearly through the fog and alerted Victorians to a new idea, that help was at hand wherever the blue lamp was found.
So, where did we begin? It did have a crown on there.
So one bit's missing?
One piece is missing. The frame itself, if you look underneath this paint, right, the original patination, the green verdigris on it, is still there. That's what we want to get to.
Yeah.
The next section would have been single pieces of curved white or opaline glass. You can see the remnants of it here.
Corroded.
That is the original glass. And that piece is incorrect.
Yeah.
This is the correct one.
Oh, yeah.
I think this is an original and/or period piece, so that can be done.
How is this going to stand up?
Well, from a previous job, we've got a cast iron post. It works. It'll go with it. The good thing is we paid literally nothing for it, because it is worth nothing. I mean, look at it. Every single bit is damaged and broken. There's nothing going for it, apart from the fact it still exists.
I'll be able to do something with that. I know I will.
All right, cool. We'll get it brought down to you.
Brilliant.
Cheers.
Thanks.
There's an awful lot of processes here. Wrought iron restoration, into patination, into painting, into glazing, into wiring, and then structural on the inside as well. It's the full Monty.
So this is part of the crown, I believe. It's incomplete. That would have sat like this to make crown shape. I really like the idea of refashioning this crown.
Crowns on police lanterns are commonly based on the 13th century St. Edward's crown, used at the coronation of British monarchs. The design is four half arches, interspersed with fleur-de-lis. Lighting restorer Jolene has had her work cut out, restoring a battered Victorian police lantern for dealer Drew. She's repaired the metalwork, but still has to replace the glass, and importantly, the blue panes etched with the word police.
Bespoke glass is seriously difficult stuff to work with. Acid etching and flash glass, that's never been on a lantern I've worked on before.
She's subcontracted the glasswork to a specialist in the West Midlands, and she's come to Alistair Malcolm's workshop in Stourbridge to oversee the process.
Hello.
Hello. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Yeah. Well, let's go over and have a look at the metalwork you said.
Brilliant.
We were quite impressed with it. It's a lot larger than I thought from the pictures, to be honest.
Jolene sent the lantern and broken glass to Alistair in advance for measuring up.
What we've had to do to start with is to source some large sheets of what's called flash glass. It's been made by hand, so you can see a lot of bubbles in the glass.
I can feel that.
But this is clear on the top, and we've got a very thin layer of blue underneath. The idea is that we will engrave through the layer of thin blue glass to reveal the clear underneath, and that will in itself create the lettering.
The blue glass is for the sides of the lamp. Alistair's wife, Terry, is in charge of glass cutting. With the panes cut out, a prepared lettered template is put on, and it's time for sandblasting, Alistair's area of expertise.
Right, let's pop this in here.
How long does it take to actually get down to that clear glass?
I'll be blasting away an area about the size of a 2p. It'll probably take 5 minutes to get through that layer. You can just see the clear there now. I'm watching it like a hawk because the last thing I want to happen is that I go too deep and go through the clear glass too much, but also if a little bit of our masking tape comes off and we start to blast through the blue, I can't put the blue back. It's got to be carefully done. Okay, we'll get it out and have a look and see how that's gone so far. So there we go. Yeah, go ahead.
Very fine.
Yeah, it's really fine. If anything, it's a finer finish than the original actually is. From a distance, it's going to look great though, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Can we hold it up to the light?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, wow, yeah. Looks spot on.
An hour later, one pane is done.
Yeah, this has come out really well, hasn't it?
Oh, it makes it all worthwhile when you see it. It's a lot of work. It's
yeah.
It's been a good day. Thank you very much for letting me come.
You're welcome.
So now that I've seen one of those panes of glass, I'm really getting a feel of what it's going to look like in the end. And it's really going to change it. It's got a lot of character.
A few days later, Jolene returns to North Wales to hand the police lantern back to Drew.
I'm not sure Drew knows exactly what it's going to look like, so I hope it's what he had in mind. I mean, we have to wait and see.
If we hadn't done something with it, it would have been scrap. There was hardly anything left to repair. So I'm very much looking forward to seeing what she's created out of this. Hello, hello.
Hi, Drew.
How are you doing? You all right?
Yeah,
good to see you. This looks magnificent.
Thank you.
Amazing. What a thing. It was just a crushed wreck, wasn't it, last time? And I'm glad you've reused this as well.
Do you want to see it lit up?
Please. Starts to come to life.
And let's turn the lights off, see it properly.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Really effective.
Super clear.
Yeah.
And you can feel how deep that etching is.
Yeah. Acid etched?
No, sandblasted.
Sandblasted?
Oh.
It's got much better since last time I did it. Let's stick the lights back on so we can have a proper look at it. Yeah, it's come out well. So you've got the slumped glass at the top. Mm-hmm. Always tricky because they're always different.
Yeah.
The coronet was crushed, wasn't it?
Yeah, one part was missing completely. Had to make a couple of little flame decorations as well.
Yeah.
And one just broke when I was working on it. Yeah. It'd been bent. Copper, very thin. So that was fun, colour matching it and stuff. I enjoyed that. I like the decorative stuff.
But I'm extremely pleased with the colour. So have you verdigris matched it, or was that some original underneath?
Some original, some matched. It was different on every side as well.
So the etched glass, that's a proper mouth-blown glass, and then it's had blue glass flashed across the surface and then etched through. He's done a really good job. It's bang on.
When Drew bought this antique police lamp, it was on death row. The glass was smashed, the copper crown was broken, the metalwork rusted, and it didn't light up. Jolene has handmade all the missing decorative details and scraped the metal back to reveal the natural copper verdigris. And the lettered blue glass and opaline panes make this a rare and historical piece.
Well, I'm fairly confident in the right place, I'm going to see high 3,000s for that.
Yes.
3.6, 3.8. And it's probably one of the nicest ones around. It's a really, really nice job. Thank you very much. Marvellous. Perfect.
Thanks.
I'll go and get the lads to move it for you.
Lovely.
I do feel we've saved a rare, desirable and large piece of social history that was on the brink of falling to pieces. So I think overall, no matter what the finances are, it was worth the project.
Jobs like this take way longer than you ever expect because you can just continue working on them forever. Finding the moment to stop and step back is hard. I would quite happily continue working on it right now.